This tutorial is sponsored by my friends at Storyblocks.com. Storyblocks has the largest library of high-resolution, royalty-free graphics, photos, vectors, and illustrations that you can download and use. They're giving away a free 7-day subscription so you can try it out and explore their massive library of over 400,000 high-resolution images. Go to storyblocks.com/YouTube or click the link in my video's description below the title of this video to get your free 7-day subscription. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create the look of woodcut portraits from photos. This is an update of tutorials I've done in the past. This version is quicker and more flexible. I provided this wood texture that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files below. You can find hundreds of fantastic high-resolution wood textures at storyblocks.com. Open a photo of someone or something that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the other, again, from Storyblocks. The first step is to make a selection around our subject so we can separate it from its background. For this example, I'll make a selection just around his face since that's what I'd like the portrait to be. I'll zoom into his face by pressing the Z key on my keyboard to open the zoom tool and drag it over the face. I'll open the quick selection tool to make the selection. If you're using this tool as well, drag it over your subject's head to select it. If you want to remove areas outside your subject, press Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check the selection, press Q to make it into a quick mask. Press Q again to revert it back into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut it out and copy it. To place your subject onto the wood texture, press V to open your Move tool and drag your subject onto the tab of the wood texture. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Drag it to the middle. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you don't see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black-white. Presently, the adjustment layer is affecting all the layers below it. However, we want to restrict it to just our subject. To do this, either click the clipping mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. We'll convert our black and white subject into a smart object so we can continue to add filters to it non-destructively and be able to adjust those filters at any time. To do this, shift-click our subject to make it active as well and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Photocopy. Make the detail 11 and the darkness 46. Go to Select and Color Range. Choose Shadows. Make the fuzziness 0% and the range 90. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. If you want to remove unwanted spots on your subject, first, we'll invert our foreground and background colors by pressing X on our keyboard. Now, black is our foreground color. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make the hardness and opacity both 100%. To adjust the size of your pencil, first, make sure your caps lock key is off, and then press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the unwanted spots to mask them out. Change its blend mode to soft light. Click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is down, and the size is 4 pixels. The angle is 120 degrees, and the altitude is 30 degrees. The highlight mode is linear dodge, the color is white, and the opacity is 35%. The shadow mode is linear burn, the color is black, and its opacity is also 35%. To make our portrait easier to see, make a copy of the layer and reduce its opacity to 30%. Lastly, we'll increase the overall contrast of our woodcut. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. In the input shadow field, type in 26, and in the input highlight field, type in 242.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.